Hi guys, and welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've been here before. My name is Leslie and I make videos all about luxury, shopping, sometimes Korea, so if that sounds like a thing, definitely consider subscribing. I put out videos twice a week, usually on Tuesdays and Thursdays, or Fridays. I'm leaning more towards Thursdays, but either way, you'll get two new videos from me each week and I would love to have you back. So as you might have been already able to tell from the title of today's video, today is going to be a special one because I'm filming yet another collection video. I filmed my SLG, or small leather goods collection, a while back at this point. I'll leave a link to that one in the description box in case you haven't seen that one yet. But yeah, today we're going to focus on Chanel costume jewelry. And if you follow me over on my Instagram, which by the way is Leslie Adina, all spelled together, feel free to check me out over there. You might know that I do have a soft spot for luxury handbags, obviously, but also for Chanel earrings in particular. I also own a couple of brooches, but earrings is definitely where my heart lies in terms of Chanel jewelry. And over the years, I did accumulate quite a number of pieces, so I thought, why not share those with you? And yeah, let's get started. Obviously, I feel like I have to insert a quick disclaimer. I'm not filming this video to brag or show off or like rub in your face how much money I spend on, yeah, not even precious metals. I'm well aware that Chanel costume jewelry is way overpriced, but I still enjoy the occasional earring or brooch here and there. So yeah, I just thought I'd put that disclaimer out there. I am not bragging. I do not want to show off. I just want to share how happy I am with my current collection, and I bought all of the items I'm about to show you with my own money. So with that disclaimer out of the way, let's start with my first piece of Chanel jewelry, or yeah, first Chanel piece period. So this is the item that started my collection. And by the way, I'm going to go through my collection in chronological order because I'm still able to pinpoint which item I bought at which point in time. So we'll go through the items in chronological order. And this is my oldest Chanel piece. I bought that one towards the end of 2017, I believe. So yeah, we're talking about a classic, rather big Chanel pearl brooch. Obviously, the pearls aren't real. As we all know, there are no like precious metals or semi-precious stones and real pearls involved when it comes to Chanel costume jewelry. But anyway, so this is my first ever Chanel piece of jewelry. Granted, I don't wear brooches all that often, but I still think I will never get rid of this one because it does hold some sentimental value because, as I said, it's my first ever Chanel piece that I treated myself to. And yeah, I really like this one, especially come autumn and winter, because as I said, this brooch is on the larger side. So I think it's a lot more easy to style and just chuck on a big like puffy coat than on like a dainty thin jacket or blazer. So yeah, I really love this one. Haven't worn it that much, but still it's a very special piece in my collection. So next up are these super tiny dainty earrings, and they are silver with like rhinestones or like crystals all throughout the CC. I'm not too sure how well you'll be able to see them on the screen, but I'll insert a close-up try-on clip for every single pair of earrings that I'm showing in this video. But yeah, I consider these to be pretty entry level when it comes to Chanel jewelry. I think I paid 300 euros on them. That was back in January of 2018. So I don't know, they might have gone up in price since then because as we all know, Chanel does enjoy a price increase every now and then. But I think these are amazing. They are pretty understated and I do wear them quite regularly. I did have some quality issues with them. I'll link my video that I filmed on my quality problems when it comes to Chanel in the description box. I had to take them into Chanel after wearing them like 10 times and after half a year, I think, because two of those crystals had fallen out, but Chanel took care of that without charge. So that was great. And since then I have had zero problems with that. But yeah, I still am very glad I bought these, and they are classic and they are pretty understated and suitable for everyday wear, in my opinion. Next up is another pair of pretty dainty earrings, and these are even more understated because they have zero like strass or crystal stuff on them, and when you hold them against your ears they are pretty invisible, I guess, because they have this like rose-ish, like yeah, dusty rose kind of color, and the gold CC on top of that. Again, I'll insert a close-up because chances are you might not be able to tell what these look like and when they are that far away. But yeah, they are pretty dainty, again, somewhat affordable. I think they were 300 euros too. No idea what they would cost at this point in time. Also, they weren't a classic. The CC ones I showed earlier were a classic, and Chanel sells those regardless of the seasons and yeah, regardless of which time of the year it is. These were part of a, I think, Greek-inspired collection. So yeah, I think they're beautiful, super understated, very carefree, because obviously no crystals or anything that might end up falling out without you noticing. So these are amazing and I wear them quite regularly because, yeah, they are small and understated and an everyday pair of earrings for sure. So next up is another pair of earrings, and I think these mark like the end of me buying only like super tiny dainty pairs of earrings, because these are a tad bigger than the ones I showed you before, and they are super special to me because, as you might know if you've watched my Vestiaire Collective and Chanel unboxing video, and which by the way I'll also link in the description box, you know that I'm from Hamburg, Germany, and these are from the Hamburg Paris Métier d'Art collection 2018, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, these are super special to me, and also because Karl Lagerfeld was born close to Hamburg or in Hamburg, so Hamburg is very special to me, and it's a special city for the brand of Chanel and Karl Lagerfeld. So yeah, these are like dangly anchor earrings. Again, you'll see a close-up and try-on video on the screen, but yeah, I really enjoy these, and these might actually be my most worn pairs of Chanel earrings, which is kind of crazy, especially because they are not the most understated pairs of earrings, with them like being pretty big and like bright yellow gold. But in my opinion, you should wear whatever you want on a day-to-day basis, and yeah, these are amazing, and I've also worn them to the office and it felt perfectly fine. I didn't feel like self-conscious or anything, because also the CC isn't like too obvious when you're like 1.5 meters or like 2 meters away. You wouldn't really be able to tell that they're from Chanel because the CC is like the same color as the earring in general. So yeah, I think these are amazing, both like for dressy occasions but also on a day-to-day basis. Next off is another brooch, and that is this beauty right here. Again, you'll see a close-up on the screen. It's a lot smaller than the pearl brooch, just for comparison. There you have it. To be quite honest, this might be one of my least worn Chanel pieces of jewelry, which pains me to say, but yeah, that's just the way it is. A, brooches aren't something I'd wear on a day-to-day basis anyway, and B, I'm a little freaked out by the white color because I don't want to get it stained by like dirt on my hands or like makeup. So yeah, I might have only worn this particular brooch once before at max, and obviously for a couple of like Instagram flat lays, because it does look pretty, I'm not gonna deny that, but for some reason I just don't get around to wearing that one that much. So actually I put this brooch up for sale on a couple of platforms. I mean, let me know if you're interested in buying it, but yeah, I've just come to realize that I'm not that much of a brooch wearer yet. Maybe it's like an age issue, and in 10 years time I might really enjoy wearing brooches on a day-to-day basis. We'll see what happens, but for the time being, yeah, I have to admit to myself that I should stay away from brooches because I don't end up wearing them, but I mean, it is really pretty. So next came another pair of earrings, what a surprise, and those are these right here. They are from the Chanel New York Egypt Métier d'Art 2019, if I'm not mistaken. If you look closely, which you'll be able to on the screen right here, you'll see a close-up and me wearing the earrings. You'll see that they have like these hieroglyphs, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, and all throughout the CC. So yeah, these like Egyptian signs, I guess, you know what I'm talking about. These are super pretty and yeah, quite big. Let me compare them to the first pairs of earrings that I showed you. I hope you'll be able to see the difference. They are quite big and they definitely go like below my earlobe and dangle around a little, but I quite enjoy the look of them, and yeah, they are super comfortable, obviously a little more in your face, so I might stay away from wearing them to the office, but yeah, on casual days or like when you dress up a little more, these are perfect and I really like them. So next up is another pair of earrings, and it kind of pains me to say that these are actually my least worn Chanel earrings, especially considering that they were my most expensive one, like by far, and yeah, I bought them in the US, which made them even more expensive. I don't want to talk about it, but anyway, these are the Chanel like pretty long and definitely statement like solid gold, like gold colored metal earrings. They are so pretty, and yeah, I do like a good statement earring, but these are definitely pushing it in terms of what I feel comfortable wearing, and yeah, unfortunately there weren't like that many occasions where I was able and comfortable with wearing these like pretty in-your-face Chanel earrings, but I hope and like fingers crossed there will be many more to come, because they do hold some sentimental value as I bought them while I was working in the US. So yeah, they are super pretty and I don't really want to think about like actually selling them. So I have to make a point of wearing them so I can like justify keeping them in my collection, because yeah, they are really special and they were like all the rage. I think last year every like luxury YouTuber and yeah, social media influencer had them and wore them, and I think I just have to bite the bullet and wear them and not think about that they might be a little over the top for the like particular occasion. But yeah, I really love them, and I mean, when I put my hair down, which I usually wear my hair down anyway, you're not even able to see them unless I want you to see them. So yeah, that's a plus. And yeah, I love these and I really have to make a point of wearing them more often. And lastly, my most recent addition to my Chanel jewelry collection, which will come to no surprise if you've seen my Vestiaire Collective shopping guide and Chanel review video, is this brooch right here. Yes, I know, another brooch, and I know that I said that like brooches aren't my cup of tea in terms of wearing them on a day-to-day basis, but this is more for sentimental value. I won't go into the details of why this is so special to me. You can check out the video I just mentioned, but yeah, it's a brooch again from the Chanel Hamburg Paris collection, which again, Hamburg is very special to me. And yeah, they have the CC right here and the Shields of Hamburg with this like castle looking stuff in the middle. Yeah, it's really special to me, and I also went into the purchase knowing that I might not ever wear this one like out. It's more for like collectors and sentimental value, and yeah, I'm super happy to have added this one into my collection, and I got a pretty good deal on that one too. I bought this on Vestiaire Collective, and yeah, so there you have it. That was my entire Chanel costume jewelry collection. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please hit that like button and also subscribe if you haven't done that already. As I said, I put out videos twice a week all about luxury and shopping, and I would really love to have you back. And also, I would love to know your opinion when it comes to Chanel costume jewelry. As I said, I'm well aware that they are essentially a waste of money because there are no precious metals or like precious stones or anything like that involved, but I think I'm not alone when it comes to really loving some statement and also some like more understated Chanel costume jewelry pieces. But let me know your opinion when it comes to costume jewelry. As I said in my, I think it was my wishlist video, I'm definitely planning on like scaling back when it comes to costume jewelry pieces from designers, because at the end of the day, they are not like the wisest financial decision when it comes to buying luxury. I much rather like skip on buying a couple of earrings or brooches and instead buy a handbag that would bring me much more joy. But at the same time, I'm really pleased with what I have in terms of costume jewelry, and although these don't get that much love, but I'm working on changing that. But yeah, let me know your opinions, and also tell me what your favorite piece out of my collection is. I'd love to hear your opinion. And yeah, with that being said, thanks so much for watching. Again, subscribe if you enjoy these type of videos, and until next time, bye.